Hello, everybody. I think it's just wonderful to see you all. Sorry, I have to just move some windows around on my computer screen so I can see the chat if anyone feels like chatting today. I certainly hope you do, because it's fun for me when you do. Tonight is Elton John night, so I am happy to do my best to get to any requests that you may have. I'll likely be playing a lot of the songs you'd like to hear anyway, but if you want to make a request in the chat, I will, if I know it, I will play it. And we'll get started. It was interesting because last week was Billy Joel, obviously. I didn't set the monitor up today. Good, I'm glad you can hear me. So last week was Billy Joel, and this week is Elton John. And oh, I've got a bit of a delay on my end here. That's weird. Hold on one second. Oh, I don't like that. Do me a favor, because I'm hearing two of everything for some reason. So here's what I want you to do. Tell me if when you see my hand play a note, if you hear it at the same time. I'll wait for someone to comment. I'm hearing a crazy delay. I could fix it, I could just go through my interface and not through Logic, but I just had this working beautifully, and now I've got a delay. I think I'm just gonna go and play through the interface, so I don't have to waste any more time. So just give me 1 second to switch things around. Hopefully you should hear me again. If that is true, well, let me know. Let me know if you can hear me now. Just want to make sure. And also if you could hear the piano. Microphone. Yes. I'm assuming yes to both. Okay. All right. So let's jump right in. The first hit that Elton John had was, I'm going to play it. It's called Your Song. You know it. You all know it. All right, I'm getting the clear sign that everything's good, so I'm going to put my phone away so I don't get distracted by any emails that come in. Okay, so Elton John, I'm assuming we know some of this stuff, but I'll just in case you don't. Elton John doesn't write his own lyrics, right? He writes the music, and a guy named Bernie Taupin, for the most part, has written all the lyrics. Right? There's a few others throughout the years, but for the most part, it's been Bernie. And when Elton was trying to get some kind of a music career going, he had this issue that he just could not write lyrics. He was, hey, Rory, good to see you on here. Where was I? Elton wasn't actually Elton then. He was Reginald Reginald Dwight is this actually his real name. Hey, Charles. And Jim and Mom. Went to this label with some demos, some stuff, and the guy's just like, I really just don't have anything for you. But here's an envelope with some lyrics in it. See what you think. And there were lyrics that Bernie Taupin had written. And from then on, they hit it off and started writing together. They got to a point. Your song is on the Elton John album. And it was kind of a last ditch effort to just to get something on record and try to have a career. It was their second record together. The first one didn't really go anywhere. And this album didn't do much either until it went to America and it got some radio play. And so again, another last ditch effort by the label. They said, we're going to send you to LA to play a gig at the Troubadour and we'll see how it goes. And it went great. And he's had a career ever since. And this may well be the song that started it. So I'm going to start with this. Piano is too loud. Can you boost your gain on vocal? Let's see. Let's see if that makes a difference. Good, I'm glad. All right. What if I just play and sing a little? You could tell me if it's better. Let me know if that's better. I need to plug something in. For some reason, I have no vocals in my headphones. Actually, I know what I could do. Let's see. Did we get a comment? Better. Okay. Hey! Let's see. Turn my headphones up. Sorry, guys. Feel like you still might need a little bit more vocals. Yeah, that's what it sounds like to me. Hey, hey, hey. Oh. Bring the mic a little bit closer. Sorry, this is all sounding fantastic through Logic, but then we had that delay. Hey, 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 oh, oh, oh. All right. Hey, everybody. All right. Jim said that's it. Okay. We're going to continue on. And so that was your song. That was the first hit. That was what put them on the map. Okay. But if we rewind to the previous record, the very first song that Elton and Bernie really felt good about was on that record. And I want to play it for you. If you tuned into the very first concert that I did back when we were still at the church, I played it, but it's been a while. So I'm going to do it again. It's called Skyline Pigeon. It's such a beautiful song. It did end up getting released on one of his, pop records once he was established. So you might have heard it on that. It was also played on one of his live records, the one that he did at Madison Square Garden with John Lennon. But it's called Skyline Pigeon. Thank you. the smell of new mown hay, to laugh and cry, to live and die in the brightness of my day. I wanna hear the pealing bells of distant churches sing, but most of all, please free me from the aching metal ring and open up this cage towards the sun. That's Skyline Pigeon, song from the first record of Elton John's called Empty Sky. It's actually not a bad record. It's not the best either, but we're getting some thunder. This might get interesting. Going back to the first album, I'm not going to go album by album so much tonight. The thing with Elton John versus like Billy Joel or the Beatles, he made a ton of records, sometimes like multiple records in a year. And honestly, they're not all that great. The 70s stuff is, you know, was the prime and it's wonderful. But man, there was some stuff in the 80s. He made a disco album. Did you know that? There's an Elton John disco record. I don't remember the name of it, where he does a disco version of Johnny B. Goode. And it sounds like that could either be amazing or not. And I mean, there's some records where you wouldn't know a single song on them, but he just pumped them out like crazy, especially in the late 70s and 80s. So not going album by album. I kind of just made more of a set list tonight. But of course, if you have a request, I'll jump to it. So that's what we got. Gonna do a song. This is also off the Elton John record, and the purpose of that record was meant to attract established singers and artists in hopes that they would record their songs. They put a lot of production into it. They somehow convinced the label to give them a lot of money to hire a string orchestrator, and there's beautiful string arrangements throughout the whole album. If I have time, I was thinking of doing it just now, but I'm going to skip it for now. I might come back to it. Somebody wants me to play The Greatest Discovery. I'll play it later on. I did play it a few weeks ago. It's one of my favorite Elton John songs, but I am going to skip it for time's sake. Because this song called Border Song, you might know it, was actually recorded by Aretha Franklin. And it was one of the first really exciting things to happen for Elton and Bernie, was when kind of their goal of this record actually came true. And, you know, Aretha Franklin covered one of the songs. So I'm going to do it now. Holy Moses, I have been removed. I have been from down the line, brand of people who ain't my kind. Holy Moses, I have been removed. Holy Moses, I have been deceived. Now the wind has changed direction. Thank you. take any more than water, poison from my head down to my shoes. Oh. The border song, kind of relevant to what's going on these days. Balance still good, everybody. It's you might be able to tell from the first chord what song's coming next. I'm not even gonna introduce it. I'm just gonna go. Here we go. She packed my bags last night, pre-flight. 0 hour, 9 a.m. And I'm gonna be high as a kite by then. I miss the earth so much. I miss my wife. It's lonely out in space. Such a timeless flight. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time till touchdown brings me round again to find I'm not the man I think I am at home. Oh, no, no, no. I'm the rocket man. Kind of place to raise the kids. In fact, it's cold as hell, and there's no one there to raise them. If you did, and all the science I don't understand. Find I'm not the man I think I am at home. Oh, no, no, no. it's gonna be a long time. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time. All right, Rocket Man. Now, I said now like I was about to say some kind of deep thought going into the next song. But I don't have a deep thought going into the next song. But it happens to be called the same thing that I'm called. Daniel's traveling tonight on a plane. I can see the red tail lights heading for Spain. Oh, and I can see Daniel waving goodbye. God, it looks like Daniel must be the clouds in my eyes. They say Spain is pretty, though I've never been. Daniel says it's the best place he's ever seen. Oh, and he should know he's been there enough. Lord, I love Miss Daniel. Oh, I miss him so much. Oh, Daniel, my brother, you are older than me. Do you still feel the pain of the scars that won't heal? Your eyes have died. You see more than I. Daniel, you're a star in the face of the sky. Older than me, do you still feel the pain of the scars that won't heal? Your eyes have died, but you see more than I. Daniel, you're a star in the face of the sky. Daniel is traveling tonight on a plane. I can see the red taillights heading for Spain. Oh, and I can see Daniel waving goodbye. God, it looks like Daniel must be the clouds in my eyes. Oh, God, it looks like Daniel. It must be the clouds in my eyes. Daniel, you know what would be really cool is if my mom told me that I was named after that song. I don't think I was, but it would be cool if I was. Just food for thought. Yes, I will do Mona Lisas and Mad Hatters in a little bit. Promise. By the way, tonight I have a margarita of sorts, but instead of being made with tequila, it's made with mezcal, which is kind of my new favorite, not favorite, but a new discovery. I never had it before, but it's made from the agave plant, just like tequila is, but instead of being distilled right away, it's smoked. So it's kind of tastes like tequila with a smokiness to it. It's good. And I do have a recipe for our midway point, but it is not this. It's something else. All right. We're gonna speed things up a bit. This is a song. It's actually the same album that Mona Lisa's of Mad Hatters is from, called Honky Chateau. And that whole record was really a love song to New York City and to American life. I think, you know, they had finally had a good taste of it. And so a lot of those songs on that record specifically are all about primarily New York City, but just kind of that American city life. Fishing in a stream, looking for an answer, trying to find the sign. Until I saw your city lights, honey, I was blind. They said, get back, honky cat, better get 'em back to the woods. Well, I quit those days and my redneck ways, and I. City to where it's at. It's like trying to find gold in a silver mine. It's like trying to drink a whiskey, oh, from a bottle of wine. Well, I read some books and I read some magazines about those high class ladies down in Orleans and all the fools back home. Well, since I was a fool, they said, oh, believe in the Lord, it is the golden rule. They said, get back, honky cat, better get them back to the woods. Well, I quit those days and my redneck ways, and I. They said, get back, honky cat, better get 'em back to the woods. Well, I quit those days and my redneck ways, and I, oh, 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 change is gonna do me good. They said, stay at home, boy, you gotta tend the farm. Says no, oh, 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 stop when your feet say go. You better get back, honky cat, better get 'em back to the woods. Well, I quit those days and my redneck ways, and I, ooh, 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 oh, the change is gonna do me good. Better get back, honky cat, living in the cities where it's at. It's like trying to find gold in a silver mine. It's like trying to drink a whiskey, oh, from a bottle of There's a little honk a cat. Sad songs. I can attempt sad songs. I think I have it. Candle in the Wind is not too cliche, but I have to play it at the end. It's just kind of a rule. I'm going to jump to some requests. I had them a little further down in the list. Let's see. Mona Lisa's and Mad Hatter's. Where did I have that one? There it is. All right. This is Mona Lisa's and Mad Hatter's. Another love letter to New York City. Now I know Spanish harm are not just pretty words to say. Thought I knew, but now I know that rose trees never grow in New York City. Until you've seen this trash can dream come true. Stand at the edge while people run you through. And I thank the Lord there's people out there like you. I thank the Lord there's people out there like you. While Mona Lisa's and Mad Hatter's, sons of bankers, sons of lawyers. Turn around and say good morning to the night. For unless they see the sky, but they can, and that is why. They know not if it's dark outside or light. This Broadway's got, it's got a lot of songs to sing. If I knew the tunes, I might join in. I go my way alone, grow my own, my own seed shall be sown in New York City. Subway's no way for a good man to go down. Hobo, he can drown. I thank the Lord for the people I have found. I thank the Lord for the people I have found. While Mona Lisa's and Mad Hatter's, sons of bankers, sons of lawyers, turn around and say, can, and that is why. They know not if it's dark outside or light. And now I know Spanish Harlem are not just pretty words to say. I thought I knew. Now I know that rose trees never grow in New York City. Subway's no way for a good man to go down. Rich man can ride, while the hobo he can drown. And I thank the Lord for the people I have found. Can, and that is why. They know not if it's dark. dark outside or light. You know not if it's dark outside or light. All right. Oh, thanks. Hi, Uncle Ron. Oh, Rory, I'm glad you're enjoying it. Benny and the Jets. Ah, I'll do that one, too. Let me see if I have sad songs. In there. Let me see if I have it in the book. Not one I know super well, so we'll... But I'll try it. Alright. Let's see what happens. Okay. I need to adjust the lighting's a little bit different tonight, wouldn't you say? You can't see. I gave myself a haircut today. I can't even tell. Might need to move the light around. The light is really weird outside tonight, too. I don't know if we're getting a storm, but it's like, I don't know, orange outside. It's weird. All right, so this is Sad Songs Say So Much. Maybe. Yes, there are times when we all need to share a little pain. It's fine, I don't know the words. I'm struggling to see the words. We're ironing out the rough spots with a little pain. And it's time that there's all the need to. I just can't read the words. It's too dark in here. I'm just going to give up on that one. You stumped me. I just can't see the words. Sorry. Come up with a different one and I'll play it, but I just don't know that one well enough. I'm just going to make up all the words. Do, 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 do. We talked about this a little bit last week with our kind of our little history lesson. About how in the 70s, because of the business structure of FM radio, a lot of pop artists would put a handful of longer songs on their records because that's what FM was really playing a lot of. They would play just entire albums. They would play long cuts, whereas AM was more of the 3-minute singles. So just like Billy Joel last week, we saw a couple of his longer songs. Elton John also has a couple. And I've got two of them programmed tonight. This first one is called Tonight. Thank you. tonight? Do we have to fight again tonight? I just wanna go to sleep. Tonight. Interesting connection is that was on the album called Blue Moves, and I think around that time the film composer James Newton Howard, before he was a film composer, he was the keyboard player in Billy Joel's band. Might not know that. And he also did a lot of string arrangements during his tenure with the Elton John band. Originally, a man named Paul Buckmaster was the orchestrator for all of Elton John's music, first several albums. All those string parts were by Paul Buckmaster, who was a really, like, crazy guy. He was a cellist, but did some really brilliant arrangements. But later in Elton John's career, it was James Newton Howard before he was a film composer. That eventually he left the Elton John band to pursue a film composing career, and he is probably one of the top, at least 10, most famous film composers of our time. All right. Next up, this is a song called from, what's the name of that record? Captain Fantastic and the Brown Dirt Cowboy. Am I saying that wrong? This song is kind of autobiographical. Well, if Elton wrote the words, it would be autobiographical. But I believe Elton John had entered into a marriage with a woman. I mean, we all know Elton John is gay. I think we all know that. But he's been married to two or more women in his life. And the first wife was, it was just, it was a really bad move. Bernie kind of saved him from this relationship. And this was the song that's somewhat about that. Think of those East End lights, muggy nights, curtains drawn in a little room downstairs. Prima donna love, you really should have been there, sitting like a princess perched in her electric chair. And it's one more beer, and I don't hear you anymore. You've all gone crazy lately. Friends out there rolling round the basement floor. Someone saved my life tonight, sugar bear. Almost had your hooks in me. Showers, slip noose hanging in my darkest dreams. Strangled by a haunted social scene, just a pawn outplayed by a dominating queen. It's 4 o'clock in the morning, damn it, listen to me good. I'm sleeping with myself tonight, saving time. Stocks and bonds, playing your HP demand.
Someone save my life tonight. So save your strength and run the field you play along. Someone save my life tonight. Sugar bear, almost had your hooks in me. Didn't you, dear? You nearly had me roped and tied. Altar bound, hypnotized.
Obviously, someone saved my life tonight. Good song. All right, we're going to go to... I think I'm going to skip that one. Might come back to that one. We're going to jump to the 80s. Y'all know this one. It's forever. Between you and me, I could honestly say that things could only get better. While I'm away, dust out the demons inside, and it won't be long before you
why they call it
Good. I'm glad that made up for sad songs because I really blew that one. Fantastic tonight. I don't, if that, thank you if that's a compliment. If it's an Elton John song, I don't know it. I'm surprised there aren't more requests coming from my dad because he's a big Elton John fan. He likes the deep cuts, which I have some of, but you gotta kind of ask for them. How are we doing? Let's keep going. Here's one you all know, and I hope you sing along at home.
Auditorium. Love.
All right. Tiny Dancer. So, been going for a little over an hour. I've got a lot of music left to do. I'm going to take a little break. And in the meantime, I will teach you how to make the classic New Orleans cocktail called the Sazerac. I'm going to switch it over to the wait screen that you see in the beginning of the show for just a second while I load the video, because I forgot to do that previously. I'm going to get a drink. Well, I have a drink, but I'm going to just drink some water, rehydrate, and we'll be right back with some more Elton John. So here we go. So tonight's cocktail is the Sazerac. It is a classic cocktail that's come from the city of New Orleans. It's kind of been forgotten about. It's hard to order one that a bar would be stocked with the ingredients necessary to make it, but it's not too hard to make one at home. Here's what you need. You need a whiskey. This is leaning toward more towards the rye on this one. There's not much not much debate on which whiskey you should use. Go with rye. Again, I have Old Overhaul, just like last week. I use Pernod. There's a Pernod, I don't know if you pronounce the D, which is an anise-flavored liqueur. Traditionally, you would use absinthe, which you can also use. That's what was originally used. But then absinthe became illegal for several decades, so a lot of people switch to this. Now you can use both, either will do. You need bitters. Traditionally, Pei Chaud's. I like just a little bit of Angostura as well. You need some simple syrup or a sugar cube. I'm using simple syrup for this one because there's no muddling involved. Okay, and then just some equipment. All right, first thing I'm gonna do, this is so super important. I'm gonna take the glass that I'm gonna make the drink in. I'm gonna put some ice in it. And I'm gonna fill it with water. All right, this is called chilling the glass, all right? This is important. If you're ever gonna have a cocktail served up, meaning in a glass with no ice, but it should be chilled. The glass should be chilled. If you're at a bar and you order a martini and the bartender does not chill your glass, you should ask him to, because it makes such a difference. So that while that's chilling, we're gonna prepare the drink. Just a mixing vessel here. Again, I'm gonna start with my least expensive ingredients and work my way up. So simple syrup, about a teaspoon. I'm just gonna eyeball it. There we go. If you use a sugar cube, that's automatically measured to one teaspoon. So good to know. Two dashes of Pei Chaud's, and this is how I like mine. One, two, and then one dash of Angostura bitters. Just one, give it a good, there you go, okay? Then we take our rye, I'm almost out of this, and it's gonna be 2 ounces. So let's measure. And two. Might have just enough left in here to make this for you. No, it's actually for me. I'm gonna drink it, you're not. all right, there's a little bit left. We'll do a shot later. All right. We're not adding this in yet. I'm not forgetting anything, don't worry. So now we take some ice. I just have a bowl of ice over here.
and I forgot my bar spoon in the kitchen, so I'm just gonna swirl this around, all right? We're just mixing, we're chilling what's in here, while also melting some of the ice, so you're getting a little bit of water in there as well. All right, that feels cold, I'm gonna put that aside. All right, going to dump my water. Now here is the really cool thing with this drink. All right, we take our Pernod or our absinthe, and we just put, I'm not gonna measure, just eyeball, just a little bit on the bottom of the glass. This is what's called a rinse. We swirl it around. I'll show you how I do this. I just have a bowl here. And here's what I do. You tip it, but don't tip it so everything falls out, and you're just gonna rotate the glass. What's happening is the liqueur is coating the sides of the glass, and you do that all the way down. Keep rotating it until it's just at the lip, and then when you think it's sufficient, you just dump it out, okay? So just what's left coating the glass is all that goes in the cocktail, all right? We take our strainer, we strain our mixture into the glass. We garnish with an expressed lemon peel. Remember last week we showed you this one? Over the top, around the lip, and in the glass. And there you go, there is your New Orleans Sazerac. Cheers! So tonight's cocktail is the Sazerac. It is.
All right, so that drink sounds great, and it's hard to believe I've never tried one. Yeah, they're really good, Charles. I don't know what to say. That's one of my favorite cocktails of all time. I was able to plug in my monitor while you were watching that, so now I don't need to wear these headphones and sweat my face off, even though it's still kind of hot, but it's probably 10 degrees cooler than it was last week. Gonna get to some requests right now. This one is called Benny and the Jets.
Spaced out. Betty and the Jets. Oh, the wind and the wonderful. Oh, man, she's really keen. She's got electric boots, a moe suit.
Quite the arts of the cocktails. Yeah, man. You need something to keep you occupied during quarantine, right? So Benny and the Jets, there was another request. What was the get out of the way? Madman. Okay, I think I could do that. I think I can do that. Oh, it gets really high, doesn't it? I don't know. They're all really high. I'm doing pretty much all original keys. Except for some of the ones that I've done before that I've already written out in different keys. But, you know, we're going for it. I think my voice has gotten higher. One thing I forgot to mention last week. On Billy Joel Night. Is. It really seems to me. That Billy Joel's range got higher and higher. The songs like on the River of Dreams album are so high. Whereas like the earlier songs are much easier to sing. It's like as he progressed, his voice got higher, or he just strained too much because now he does everything like, you know, down a couple steps. But it makes me wonder if that album and then touring on that album, singing all the songs every night for a few years, did some vocal damage because now he takes everything down, which is fine. There's nothing wrong with that. I do it all the time and I'm not, you know, famous. I'm just me. So, I meant to mention that last week. But anyway, all of Elton John's songs are high. I'm just going for it. This is called Madman Across the Water. It's from the album Madman Across the Water. Same record that Tiny Dancer is from. It's kind of a weird song, but my dad likes it, so I'm going to try to play it. I can see everywhere there's a boat on the reef with a broken back, and I can see it very well. My page doesn't turn when I hit my pedal because I have to turn it with my hands. There's a joke and I know it very well. One of those that I told you long ago. Take my word, I'm a madman, don't you know? Once a fool and a good part in a play. If it's so, would I still be here today? It's quite upsetting in a funny sort of way. Very funny, everything I say. Get a load of hell, me so insane. You better get your coat, dear. It looks like rain. We'll come again next Thursday afternoon. Till we lost it. You're after another glimpse of a madman across the water. Well, I can see everywhere there's a boat on the reef with a broken bay.
could see very well. Why, there's a joke, and I know it very well. It's one of those that I told you long ago. Take my word, I'm a madman, don't you know?
Grounds along with Adams.
Is the night more black than this window's painted? Will they come again next week? You're the man I'm taking. We'll come again next Thursday afternoon. The in-laws hope they'll see. That you're after. Another glimpse of a madman across the water.
Something like that. It was close. Funny thing with that particular song, when they were recording that record, I can't remember the producer's name, Gus something, produced all of Elton John's early albums. And just like Billy Joel, this is the common thing in the 70s where solo artists had a touring band, but when they went to the studio to record, they'd use studio musicians, usually at the discretion of the producer. Touring and recording are two different beasts, and you know, touring musicians of the time were really good at learning a set of songs, committing them to memory, playing them every night. But in terms of being in a studio and coming up with new parts in all this, sometimes it would take them longer. And the longer things take, the more money it costs. So producers like to use studio musicians who are used to, all right, brand new song, heard it once, and here's what I'm going to play. And they get it done. So sometimes to balance it out, producers would allow the touring band to play on one track on the album. So that was kind of the norm for the first couple Elton John albums. But in the early 70s, Elton was only touring with a bassist and a drummer. And they both sang. So, I mean, there's a really great live record from 1971 with just the three of them. It's amazing. Gus Dudgeon, very good. Thanks, Wikipedia. And around Madman, he was thinking about adding a guitarist, and the producer wanted to use guitar on that song that I just played, Madman Across the Water. And so he brought in Davey Johnston, who was mainly an acoustic player. That's what he had mainly done. And he played acoustic on that track. If you listen to the track, that whole intro, that's all guitar. That's not actually piano. It's all guitar. And Elton liked Davey so much. He's like, you know, I think I'm going to ask him to play in the touring band. And Gus was like, no, he's an acoustic player. He's not going to be able to rock out. He was wrong. And Davey's been playing with Elton since like 1974 or something. Great guitar player. Gonna jump back to what is quite, most people would say that Goodbye Yellow Brick Road is the quintessential Elton John record. It's actually, it's two discs. You know, it's two records, so it's almost 90 minutes of music. And this is what opens the album. This is a brave album opening. It's the, there are two songs, but they're always played together. It's Funeral for a Friend and Love Lies Bleeding in My Hands. This is another one of those longer ones I was telling you about. This is the other one that I'm going to play.
Thank you. cafes another day.
Goodbye, Yellow Brick Road. I can do that one. Here it is, the title track from Goodbye, Yellow Brick Road. A lot of the songs on Goodbye, Yellow Brick Road had a kind of a Hollywood theme to them.
When are you gonna come down? When are you going to land? I should have stayed on the farm. I should have listened to my old man. You know you can't hold me forever. I didn't sign up with you. I'm not a present for your friends to open. This boy is too young to be singing the blues. Shoot down the plane. It'll take you couple of vodka and tonics to set you on your feet again. Maybe you'll get a replacement. There's plenty like me to be found. Mongrels who ain't got a penny, sniffing for tidbits like you on the ground. Dogs of society howl. You can't plant me in your penthouse. Going back to my plow, back to the howling old owl in the woods, on the horny black toad. Oh, I finally decided my future lies beyond the yellow brick road.
Go Yellow Brick Road. Let's see, where do we want to go next? That song, my past couple songs were pretty high, so I'm gonna do a take it down a notch. While I don't know, Jim, what is your next request? Oh, you want to hear Candle in the Wind? I will play Candle in the Wind. You have to stick around. this is a ballad off of one of my favorite albums of his called Tumbleweed Connection. It was a fun album. Him and Bernie were, I don't know, obsessed with like the American frontier and the Old West and the Civil War. And all of the songs, not that this one is, but most of the songs have that flair to them. This one is just really pretty. It's called Come Down in Time. In the quiet silent seconds, I turned off the light switch and I came down to meet you in the half light the moon left while I cluster and nightjar sang some songs out of tune. A metal bright light shone down from a room. Come down in time. I still hear her say so clear in my ear, like it was today. Down in time was the message she gave. Come down in time and I'll meet you halfway. Well, I don't know. Love like hers is a hard love to get, and I've walked most all the way, and I ain't heard her call, and I'm getting to thinking she's coming at all. Come down in time, I still hear her say so clear. Come down in time was the message she gave. Come down in time and I'll meet you halfway. There are women
Some hold you tight while some leave you counting the stars in the night.
That's it. It's a good song. Gonna stick with that same album. This is my dad's favorite record too, I think. A little more up tempo. This is a song called Amarina. It was recently in the Rocket Man movie.
Like a puppy, like like a puppet child.
Amarina. All right, let's see. How are we doing? Let's do... What have I skipped so far? Should I go back to anything? Did that. Oh, we're doing good. We're hitting everything. All right, let's do this one. You all know this one. Yeah, burnt up 3 LPs in college. Feel free to throw in some more requests, y'all. Mess that up.
You can never know what it's like. Your blood like when it freezes just like ice. So there's a high level that now that shines from you. But you wind up like the wreck you hide behind that mask you use. Did you think this fool could ever win? Well, look at me, I'ma come back again. I got a taste of love in a simple way. And if you really know why I'm still standing, you just fade. Little kid, and I'm still standing. still standing.
Could probably do Sacrifice. Do I have it on here? Yeah, I think I could do Sacrifice. I'll change it to my cheesy electric piano sound. There we go. It's a human sign when things go wrong, when the sin of her lingers and temptation strong into the boundaries of each married man. Sweetness, it comes calling and negativity lands. Cold, cold heart, hard done by you. Some things looking better, baby, just passing through. It's no sacrifice, just a simple word. It's two hearts living in two separate worlds. But it's no sacrifice. No sacrifice at all.
I gotta change it to the other cheesy piano sound. It'll be better.
You chose her standing after the fact. Sensitivity builds a prison in the final act. We lose direction. Stone unturned, no tears to damn you. When jealousy burns, cold, cold hearts are done by you. Some things look better, baby, just passing through. And it's no sacrifice, simple word. It's two hearts living in two separate worlds. But it's no sacrifice. It's no sacrifice. It's no sacrifice at all. Cold hearts are done by you. Some things looking better, baby, just passing through. it's no sacrifice, just a simple word. Two hearts living in two separate worlds, but it's no sacrifice, no sacrifice, there's no sacrifice at all, no sacrifice at all, no sacrifice at all.
There you go, sacrifice. All right. All right. I'm going to play. It's 9:30. Been going for about 2 hours. All right. I'm going to play 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more songs. Probably go to about 10. Okay. I'm going to give you a choice on one of them. Would you rather hear Levon or Saturday Night's All Right for Fighting? During the next song, make comments and I will pick whichever one gets more votes.
Time and I
All right. Well, it looks like just my mom commented. That's all right. I'll do Levon. There's your Levon. Either was fun. Levon was great. Did really enjoy the rendition of Saturday Night in Rocket. Oh yeah, the movie was fantastic. I thought it was really good. Very much historically inaccurate, but it's really okay. All right, here we go. We got three left. Unless somebody wants something else, I'll try to do it. Lie. No more of your
pictures seem to fade to black and white. I'm grown tired, time stands still before me. Frozen here of my life, too late to save myself from falling. I took a chance and changed your way of life. There's always someone else I see. Just allow a fragment of your life to wander free. But losing everything, it's like the sun's going down on me. Discard me just because you think I mean your harm. But these cards I held, oh, they need love to help them heal. Don't let the sun go down. There's always someone else I see. Just allow a fragment of your life to wander free. But losing everything, it's like the sun. Thank you.
So the other thing, I think what really is relaunched the word for his career was in the 90s when he started writing music for Disney movies. Or maybe it was really just Lion King, but that I think that's what really gave his career the second boost, right? I did Can You Feel the Love Tonight a few weeks ago, so I'm going to do the other one.
Circle of life.
of life.
Circle of life. I must have seen Lion King 16 million times when it came out that summer. Millions of, yeah, saw a lot of that movie. All right, took my last sip of the drink, which means we must be at the last song. This is dedicated to Jim Lertzma, who's been waiting all night to hear a song about Marilyn Monroe. It's Candle in the Wind.
Goodbye, Norma Jean. Though I never knew you at all, you had the grace to hold yourself while those around you crawled. Crawled out of the woodwork and they whispered into your brain. They set you on the treadmill and they made you change your name. But it seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing who to cling to when the rain set in. I would have liked to have known you, but I was just a kid. Your candle burned out long before the legend ever did. Loneliness was tough, the toughest role ever played. Hollywood created a superstar. Pain was the price you paid. Even when you died, all the press still hounded you. All the papers had to say was that Marilyn was found in the news. And it seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing. Something more than sexual, more than just our Marilyn Monroe. And it seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing who to cling to when the rain set in. And I would have liked to have known you, but I was just a kid. The candle burned down long.
Go, Candle in the Wind. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. Hope you enjoyed. Looks like we have folk music next week. Don't know how many requests I'll be taking. I'll pretty much be playing all of the folk songs that I know. So I might get to one you like. I might not too. I really don't know that many. Anyway, just wanted to switch it up a little bit. Thanks for tuning in. Really great to see everybody virtually. Hope you enjoyed. And I will see you later.